are just some of the complaints about New Orleans Police Department cars.
And according to one police organization, it's more than just an image problem. It's also an issue of safety for police and citizens of New Orleans. WDSU anchor Rachel Wolf has this I-Team investigation.
When insiders told us that there were more and more NOPD units on the street in disrepair, the WDSU I-Team decided to take a closer look.
And the fact is, how can you respect the police department if you're not giving the equipment that looks good and works well to serve the citizens?
Drive down the street and you'll find New Orleans police cars with damage. In a matter of hours, WDSU found one outside the 6th District Station with a cracked headlight and front end damage. This one in the CBD with a scrape on the fender and what appeared to be a damaged headlight. And outside police headquarters, we found a van with a dented bumper. While some of the damage may seem minor, Raymond Burkhart, who represents the Fraternal Order of Police, says it paints a larger picture.
But it really becomes a safety issue, and it reflects badly upon the city and the department if the citizens are seeing vehicles that look shoddy.
There are more than 1,000 NOPD units on the street. 60% are 2006 or older, 40% 2008 and newer. Each year, Superintendent Ronald Surpass says between 80 and 100 cars are replaced.
And the cars that we're losing are the ones that are the newer ones because they're in the field 24/7 around the shifts.
But the FOP worries not enough are being replaced or even repaired. Here's why.
I've had complaints from officers doing Mission 1 where they've stated, we've gone out to do Mission 1, but they don't have enough vehicles in working order to actually get out on the street. You're hearing stories about officers 2, 3, and 4 in one vehicle, which is far cry from the one-man edict that supposedly is supposed to be following.
I've never heard anybody tell me that there was a third officer riding in the back seat of a marked police car with a prisoner. That would not be something that we would support and certainly want to know more about.
Superintendent Surpass says safety is a priority.
And when a vehicle is safe to operate, we operate it. If a vehicle is unsafe, we won't operate it.
But balancing financial resources with a limited budget means making tough decisions.
What I do choose is to keep officers employed and support staff employed so we can go out into the field. Sometimes how we get into the field, we need to do a better job of, and managing the fleet is just one of the many balls in the air that we have to manage.
Like many cities across the country, he's had to do more with less, and that means keeping vehicles in service as long as possible.
And 100,000 miles for a police car is not desirable, but it's not unheard of. A lot of cars will get that many miles on them and you can transition them. They're still a good car.
Surpass says when vehicles need repairs, officers can report it with a vehicle service request form. We found one on this cop car with major front end damage outside police headquarters. They are then repaired at the equipment maintenance division. But seeing cars with damage, any kind of damage, operating out on the street raises questions about what else could be wrong under the hood.
The fact is, if you have inoperable equipment or equipment that's damaged, it could fail. When that equipment fails, it could injure somebody, especially a police officer who's driving it. We don't want that. And if we're taking another officer on the street because he or she's been injured by failed equipment, that just leads to priority one's problem again, manpower.
With Surpass touting a one car, one cop concept, manpower and equipment will be a top priority during budget talks with the city this June. Until then, many cops are asking why spare vehicles like these at NOPD headquarters aren't put into service. Surpass says they are only for emergencies.
If a district falls short because of some wrecks or because of something that happens with some fleet issues, we've got a handful of cars that we can move around all the districts.
This is endemic of a greater problem. Are we allocating our financial resources in the proper place to ensure quality services from the city of New Orleans?
The NOPD says there are 435 vehicles assigned to the 8 different districts and that 384 cars are working right now. The roughly 550 other vehicles are assigned to bureaus within the department. On your side in Orleans Parish, Rachel Wolf, WDSU News.